Hello YouTube, how is it going on? My name is Darek and the topic of today's episode is: are the scented candles really, really bad for you? Let's find out. So recently I'm coming across videos or even news articles that stating that the scented candles are bad for you, and that's quite concerning, especially that what we're doing here is we're making candles. So I investigated this topic a little bit and I would like to share my thoughts with you. So bad press in particular is getting the paraffin wax. And you can sort of understand it, because people who know how the paraffin wax is made, that it is basically just the byproduct of petroleum industry, can think that there is not much difference between crude oil and paraffin wax. However, we know that the paraffin wax, before it become paraffin wax, is purified and made more candle friendly. This argument also got no sense, because paraffin is approved for consumption as a food safe paraffin by FDA, so I'm not getting that argument. Another argument against the paraffin wax is 2009 research that stated that paraffin, when burning, is producing the harmful chemicals and fumes, harmful to human health. However, this research was never published anywhere that's allowed to peer reviewed, so we have no data to look at it. It's not a research really. But prior to that, in 2007, European Candle Association funded a research that examined every major type of candle wax. What researchers found, for over 300 harmful chemicals that are produced by burning candle, none of those exceed, actually all of them were well below the safety limit for humans. The next ingredient that I would like to talk about is our fragrance oil. So some people can say this might be toxic, this might be harmful as well. However, it's not Wild West in this area as well. The fragrance oils are regulated by IFRA, that is requiring the producers to go through conformity tests. So every fragrance oil you're gonna buy gonna have this conformity certificate for the fragrance oil, and that says about the maximum doses allowed in different products. For example, in candles, obviously that would be different than in bath bombs or in soaps or in lip balms. Usually for candles it's around 100%, however you can have a look. So that have to be safe as well, if we have the controlling body allowing us to use it, unless obviously someone gonna use too much, like the conformity certificate, sorry, gonna say we can use up to 10% and we're gonna use 15, then yeah, our candle will be potentially hazardous. And the last thing that makes candle is the wick, and we don't really have much to talk here, except of maybe lead containing wicks. Those are banned now in USA, I think since 2007, I'm not very, very sure about it, but they are banned in US. You can't produce the candles or import the candles that containing lead wicks. I don't think they are used in UK either. Most of the wicks that are containing any sort of metal inside, that's usually zinc at the moment. However, Yeah, that's like the only potentially hazardous part of the candle, the wick, if it's contained lead, according to science, because yeah, that was proven that the lead can cause lead poisoning in young children. So I'm gonna leave you with these informations now, so you can make your own mind up if the scented candles are bad for you or they are not. And like always, thanks for watching. See you in next episode.